The fate of close to 500,000 refugees who are holed up at the three camps in northern Kenya hangs in the balance after the government ordered that they be repatriated to Somalia within 3 months, following the Garissa University terror attack a fortnight ago, where 148 people perished under a hail of bullets.
The same way America never became the same after 9/11, Kenya is going to be different. It is not going to be business as usual. Kenya is going to change for good after Garissa.
The government's directive receiving opposition from human rights groups, who insist it contravenes the Geneva Convention on the Protection of Refugees of 1951 that Kenya is a signatory to. The criticism notwithstanding, and the government's international obligations, the executive says the refugees who fled the Horn of Africa nation due to political turmoil must pack and go.
Atusemi Dadaab ifungwe kwa sababu hatuwajali wenzetu wa kutoka kule Somalia. Dadaab imekuwa hapa miaka 20. Hata kama mtu ni mkarimu kiasi gani, akikupatia mahali pa kukaa, kuna muda inaisha.
But the United Nations Commission on Human Rights won't relocate the asylum seekers back to their motherland, at least not for now, according to the agency's spokesman Emmanuel Nyabera.
We have not received any formal or official communication from the government so far instructing us to close the camps in the Dadaab within 3 months and relocate all the Somalis across the border. We will be able to react in a more structured manner once we receive this information.
In November 2013, Kenya entered into a tripartite agreement with the government of Somalia and UNHCR on voluntary repatriation of Somali refugees living in Kenya, the government now seeming to disregard the agreement by insisting on mass repatriation of the refugees. But the deputy president insists Kenya's hospitality had been abused, with the refugee camps allegedly being turned into havens for terrorists.
We are not saying anything new. All we are saying is that we need to reduce the time it is going to take so that we can have these people go home. They say east or west, including south and north, home is best.
The National Assembly Standing Committee on Human Rights, terming the government's directive a knee-jerk reaction on the threat of terrorism. The move, however, receiving support from some lawmakers and the workers' umbrella body, KOTU.
This roadside declaration and chest thumping will not help this country.
Sifikiri kama huyo deputy president ana namna yote ya kuwatambua wale wakimbizi, kama kweli wangekuwa wanafanya kazi yao vile nitakikana, wangekuwa wamejua ni nani yuko katika nchi hii, natakaa hapa na atakaa wapi kwa muda fulani.
Lakini sasa namuunga mkono kwa kusema ya kwamba ile kambi ya Dadaab ihamishwe iende Somalia. Nilisikia mjumbe hapa anasema hao watu ni msijui 600,000, utatoa wapi logistic? Mpaka huko karibu wasukumwe tu kwa mpaka, wakifika ngambo ile wenyewe wajipange.
Now when we tell them to go back, you are told human rights. Al-Shabaab has no human rights. Those people who chase them is Al-Shabaab and the government of Somalia.
Let the UN scream, but Kenyans are crying. We do not want Dadaab. And we are saying clear and clear as Kenyans, put the wall, but put a buffer zone.
The Al-Shabaab terror group claims they had attacked Garissa University College in retaliation over the continued presence of Kenyan soldiers in Somalia. The terrorist network is also said to be pushing for the cessation of Garissa, Mandera, Wajir, Tana River, Mombasa and Kwale counties.
Mjadala ya kusema ya kwamba jeshi yetu itoke kule Somalia ni mjadala ya bure. Al-Shabaab ndio wanasema tutoke Somalia. Sasa wewe kiongozi wa Kenya unawezaje kuungana na Al-Shabaab kusema ya kwamba jeshi ya Kenya itoke Somalia? Kwani wewe ni Al-Shabaab? We are not ceding an inch of our country to any group, least of all a terrorist group.
Kenya Defense Forces soldiers have been in Somalia since October 2011 and are now part of the African Initiative on Somalia, AMISOM. Francis Gashuri, Sunday Live.